Does God send people to hell? Welcome to Coffee with Pastor B.
Give me your eyes for just one second. Give me your eyes so I can see everything that I keep missing.
This question I get a lot as a pastor. Does God send people to hell? Does God really choose to send good people to hell? I think it's a question that's built on the wrong principle, but I'd like to see if I could try and answer a little bit of that question. First of all, we have to realize that part of God's character is justice, is doing what's right, is giving what's owed, and He is also the lawgiver. So there'll be a time when people will have to reconcile what they've done with what the law is. And God has given us that exact thing in Scripture. And I've been reading a lot of the prophets lately, both John in the New Testament and all of the minor prophets in the Old Testament. And I want to read for you a couple of the scriptures that hit me this morning. The first one's in Revelation 6 and verse 16, and it says this, "And they called to the mountains and the rocks, 'Fall upon us, hide us from the face of him who sits on the throne, from the wrath of the Lamb. For the great day of their wrath has come, and who can withstand it?'" It's talking about the coming of Christ, the second coming of Jesus Christ, and the justice that will be poured out on that day. And you know, over here, Joel is saying the exact same thing. Joel was predicting the end of times and a time of justice when God will dispel and hand out what's owed. And it says this down in verse 21, "Shall I leave their innocent blood unavenged? No, I will not. The Lord dwells in Zion." That's in here, chapter 3 and verse 7, or excuse me, 21. Chapter 3, verse 21. See, we have to understand that there is a time for justice. God has withheld his justice from us for a very long time. God has withheld his justice from this earth because he hasn't come back and he hasn't destroyed us. The last time God poured out his justice upon the earth was in the time of Noah. And the time that he saved one man and his family, for the rest of the world was so evil and wicked, it had to be wiped out. But he showed grace to mankind by providing for Noah, an honorable and righteous man. See, what we have to understand is that God's character, part of his character, is his justice. That he must do what is right. That he must re-level the scales and keep things even. For God is the lawgiver. He has set down the law to us. He set it down to us in the Old Testament. He set it down to us by his very creation. And he said certain things aren't allowed. And when we sin, we break the law. And the only penalty for that is death, which is also set out in the law. For we know what the law is. We know what the rules are. And so when we don't follow them, we must be held accountable for that. See, when we look at it from a little bit different perspective, if you think about a criminal, and when we send them to jail, are we saying that the judge is sending the criminal to jail? Or are we saying that that person committed a crime and has chosen their life, has chosen the way that leads to prison? It's the same with God. People aren't sent to hell. People are choosing to go there because they've chosen to break the law. And they've chosen not to be reconciled with that law. They've chosen not to come back to God's justice and in his righteousness, in his mercy, and his grace. See, I want you to understand that too. The law isn't just the law, but there is a way out now of his wrath. And that is through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Through his grace and through his mercy and through his act upon the cross. For Jesus lived the perfect life. He lived the life that was worthy to honor God. And that life was given for us. That perfect life was given for us that the wrath of God may be satisfied. He is the perfect sacrifice. But I want you to remember that God is justice. There is a time when there will be a price for sin. There is a time when people will be judged. There is a time, and it's coming soon. Whether that time be in your death or whether that be in the second coming of Jesus Christ, whatever it is, there'll be a time when you are to held account for your actions upon this earth, whether good or bad. That's the book of works. God has one of those. Or you can follow grace and mercy when your name is found in the book of life. That is when we follow Jesus Christ. That is when we say we're not worthy of your justice, O God. We know that we can't measure up and we know we've broken the law. But we have Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, the one who chooses to give himself for us. And we will fall upon his grace and upon his mercy, and we will be redeemed But it takes a repentant heart, and it takes turning away from sin, and it takes loving Jesus Christ. For we have to remember the good stuff about God, which is in Jesus Christ, grace, mercy, love, peace, and joy. But we also have to remember that God is justice. That's just a part of his character is love. And so when we remember that, remember there is a time when the judgment will come. And if we don't believe that, then we believe in an imperfect God who is not just. And that's just not true. Thanks for joining me for a little bit of coffee this morning and a little deeper look at Scripture. God bless y'all.